Project Economy tonight. The Santa Cruz Warriors are on track to make their opening date of December 23rd. But before any basketball is played, between 60 and 100 jobs need to be filled. And they've got less than 2 months to make it happen. More on the hiring frenzy from Action News reporter Phil Gomez.
The Santa Cruz Warriors job fair takes place at the Employment Development Department along 40th Avenue Saturday from 9 to noon. But they're hoping job seekers will fill out their applications online before showing up.
And to make things run smoothly, it'd be nice if they could fill out that application beforehand. But yeah, they can still show up, and we're holding from 9 to noon. We're cutting off the line at noon.
You can fill out the job application at santacruzbasketball.com. Jobs include ushers, ticket takers, program vendors, even...
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Kaiser Permanente Arena, the home of your Santa Cruz Warriors.
That's right, even announcers. That's one of the jobs retired firefighter Brett Taylor is shooting for.
I work part-time with the American Red Cross, but I'm so excited about the Santa Cruz Warriors that I want to be a part of this.
What are you looking for?
I'm looking for the announcer job at the stadium.
The job fair comes just after the latest unemployment figures were released for September. The unemployment rate dropped to 8.8% in Santa Cruz County, the lowest it's been in 4 years.
We've started out with Target, and then we went to Forever 21, and we've had Kohl's and other employers, and then now coming this Saturday, we're having the Santa Cruz Warriors.
Once the arena is completed, city leaders believe there will be more job opportunities, not just for Warrior games, but for city-sponsored events.
And I also think that there might even be some different positions that will materialize as other kinds of events happen that are more city-oriented events. There's just so many possibilities ahead for, you know, having that kind of facility.
In Santa Cruz, Phil Gomez, KSBW Action News 8.